Dear learners, welcome to this session where we would be discussing the advantages of self-help groups, that is the SHGs. In earlier sessions, we had discussed the concept of self-help groups and why they are formed, the need for the self-help groups and how they are formed. So the whole structure we discussed, and in this session we would be discussing the benefits and the strengths of self-help groups and what are the different stages in the formation of the self-help groups in the later stage. So in this session, particularly in this session, we will be discussing the advantages. So first, we need to understand why we need to have advantages. Advantage for anything. There can be two variants, advantages and disadvantages. So we need to understand why we discuss the advantages for a specific case. In our case, it is self-help groups. So advantage means some kind of strength, some kind of benefits related to that particular area of study. So in this case, it is SHGs. There are two types of advantages related to SHGs. One is the general advantage and the other is the specific advantage. Now, general advantage, what happens is, like, it is common to all. It has a broader scope. It is wide in range. Whereas specific advantage, it has a narrower scope and it is not so broad. It is only limited to a particular group. So this kind of advantages occur in self-help groups. So when we see the general advantages, you would find that the general advantages usually happen, and thus in case of self-help groups or SHGs, usually it is related to the poor, who are isolated, who are dispersed, who do not have the power to influence those aspects that affect their lives. They have the authority to protect their own interests and they increase their opportunities once they are organized. The poor women's ability to articulate one's own demands and mobilize the collective action also is done through SHGs. Now, these are broader aspects, the general advantages. In this case, the poor, they try to help themselves. Their own group helps them by taking steps to uplift them, to improve their standards. SHGs also teaches the rural women or the downtrodden women the finer points or the finer aspects of savings. Now, in general advantages, we also have the credits which can be extended to a large extent to different parts of the society, to the downtrodden. Now, apart from the members also, this credit can be extended, facilitating the decision making capacity, so that they can think about themselves and work towards the upliftment of themselves on their own. That means self-dependency is reduced. Then it enables and empowers them to move forward and expose them to various horizons. Now, I'll give you an example. In empowering themselves and moving forward is happening basically in agriculture sector, where women are coming forward and they are exposing themselves, they are using the technology, they are using certain kinds of technological means to expose themselves and use that particular knowledge to enhance their agricultural farming. Now, it also fills in and boosts the confidence when applying for the bank loans and the ability to take on leadership roles for community work. Now, in this case, when general advantages, we are discussing the general advantages, the poor, the women, they develop an ability to take on the leadership roles and work for the community. And then the pooled resources that are important to members for use in times of crisis, and they develop a sense of security. That is very, very important for an individual, because once a person has the sense of security, the confidence level increases, and the person, be it women or men, they tend to develop that kind of self-dependency in themselves. So this is sense of security. Now coming to the specific advantages. When we talk about the specific advantages, it is the emergence of collective self-efficacy. Now this word is very important. Collective self-efficacy means that the efficiency of each and every member of the group combined together. This is known as collective self-efficacy. Now goals that are visualized by community members as external to their control are then viewed as within the grasp of their collective forces. Now in this case, I'll give you an example, a simple example. Now this is quite an old story which we have been told about by our grandparents quite often, that when you are united, you are more powerful. And when you behave as an individual or single, then your power is not it cannot be influenced. So you cannot influence people or the society with single-handed efforts. If it is a collective effort, then the impact is more. So this is known as collective self-efficacy. Then we come to the increased ability of women to mobilize the public and private sector services for their own benefits. Now, the women, they develop a certain kind of ability. I'm talking about the specific advantages in this case. So they tend to have the awareness, and then they can communicate between the public and private sector services for example, getting loans from banks, getting the schemes approved, the government schemes approved through the government organizations, etc. Then we have enhanced social status of women in family and community. With the increase of self-dependency and self-efficacy, the women improve their social status. They are not treated as weak. They have a standing in their family and the community. Then the inculcation of thrift habit. The women, they develop a kind of savings habit, because most of the time what happens is whatever the amount they get from their husbands or brothers or parents, they just use it for the household jobs or getting the rations, getting the food, getting other things, and they don't have the habit of saving. So SHGs, they inculcate the habit of saving amongst the members. Now, and the development of credit management skills. Now, this is also another important aspect where the members, they developed how to manage the credits. Now, if you're taking the loans, how to repay the loans, how to use the money in a profitable manner so that at a later stage you can repay the loans. So the development of credit management skills is also a specific advantage. Now, other specific advantages are increased income in hands of women, used for welfare of family, education of children, improved child health, improved nutrition, and of course, reducing the poverty. This is again a specific advantage. So when women become self-dependent, they understand the role and they understand, they come to know about their ability, their inherent powers. The powers not to be used in a wrong sense. So that power can be used for the welfare of the family, for the education of children, because as the awareness increases, so they also know how to develop the health of the children, the nutrition of the children, and reduce the poverty. Then this other part of the specific advantage is belonging to a group that can change the way women think about themselves and their ability to act independently. As I talked about, it is self-dependency. Then groups give women social leadership through the collective strength to lobby and campaign and achieve tasks beyond the ability of a single woman. So they can collectively achieve certain goals which they would not have achieved while being single, doing the things single-handedly. A very good example of this is the self-help groups, the women self-help groups across the country. Somewhere around in mid of April, somewhere around 20,000, more than 20,000 self-help groups, the women, they started making the masks together and supplying to the people who are in need of the masks during the pandemic, during the present COVID-19 crisis. So this is a very, very good example of combating the crisis, coping with the crisis, and understanding how we can serve the community through collective strength. Now, in this case, one thing is very important to note that apart from apart from developing their own skills or being self-dependent, they are able to help others also in turn. So it is a broader aspect. That means they are going abroad, and they are taking charge of situations which can be taken care of. Then we have groups that can help women feel valued and to know their needs, know their specific needs which can be considered. SHGs can achieve economic security for women and their families, and they increase security in the personal development also. Now they are able to stand and talk in front of others, deal with people, deal with certain kinds of unpleasant situations also, and they can take the decisions on their own. Now coming to the strengths, we have discussed two types of advantages, the general advantages and the specific advantages. Combining them together, we come to the strengths of the self-help groups. Now the self-help groups, they are comprised, we all know that they are comprised of individuals who come together for a common cause or with common experience. Now the common benefits or the strengths of SHGs are sharing the information. This is very important. One should not hide the information, because then the collective strength is not there and the conflict arises. So sharing information, the mutual support, the problem solving, overcoming the isolation, all these are the common benefits. Then we have empowerment and inclusion through non-hierarchical decision making. That means everybody is involved in decision making. It is participatory in nature. The SHGs, they provide support in difficult times. They help people deal well with the stressors. Now, I gave you an example of mask making. There are self-help groups running who are even taking care of the mental health, who are taking care of the alcoholism, etc. So there are different kinds of self-help groups which are working on these lines. Now, they also give individual SHG members the benefit of helping and being helped by someone. This is one of the main strengths, that is mutual collaboration between each other is there. They help each other, they help themselves, and they help the society. So there are three aspects: helping one's own self, helping the members in the group, helping others apart from the group, out of the group. So these are the strengths. Now, the other aspects are the emotional and the spiritual benefits. This is very, very important. In present crisis situation, this is one of the most important aspects which needs to be dealt with. Now, if you're busy, if you're doing certain kind of creative work, if you're doing certain kind of good work, that gives you emotional peace, that gives you emotional satisfaction, that gives you spiritual benefit also. It's not necessary that you join a particular group and start doing the meditation and other things that gives you the spiritual benefits. Spirituality can also be related to the kind of work you are doing, which gives you satisfaction, which gives you pleasure, which gives you a sense of belongingness. So emotional and spiritual benefits are also the strengths. Then we have the reduced dependency on the money lenders. That means the money lenders across the villages who tend to exploit them, that dependency is reduced to a large extent. The interest burden on the borrowings is reduced, because when you understand the concept of saving and investment, then this particular problem of increasing interest, it reduces to a large extent. So the gradual increase in income, slowly and slowly the income starts increasing, because you know how to save, you know how to invest and get back the returns. Definite shifts in the loaning patterns from consumption to production activities. So out of the loans, you can buy the seeds, sow the seeds and use it in the farming. They can be a poultry business, they can be a dairy business. So any kind of business can be started at a small scale through the loans received from their self-help groups, and then this can be a profit generating mechanism. And then there's a knowledge sharing also. Increased civic community involvement also is there. So that means you tend to the social mingling and the social community and a sense of belongingness through civic community involvement takes place. So these are the strengths of the self-help groups. Now let us see the structure. Where we have discussed the general advantages, we have discussed the specific advantages. Now, and combining all this, you will find that these are the problem solving advantage, the advantages of self-help groups, and we start with the problem solving part. Now, the first advantage is problem solving, then gender equality, then employment opportunity, then you have financial discipline, you have government benefits, you have social benefits, you have improved standards of living, you have the open to all, and it has the participatory nature. We will discuss this one by one. Now, the problem solving ability. When the SHE is formed, then you have the response to a common cause and you tend to fulfill that cause. Then the members of SHEs, they work in a collective manner to find a solution to the problem. Now I can give you an example of a case in a very backward town in Maharashtra, where there was a water problem. Now the villagers there, they joined hands collectively and then they tried to find out the way to generate the ponds, to make the ponds, collect the rain harvest water, the water harvesting is done, and then store the water. And slowly and slowly, within 10 years period of time, the village, initially the people started moving out of the, migrating out of the village, and there were only few people left, and they formed the self-help group and they started doing it, this work. Now it happens, if you see the present condition of that village is one of the villages which has the most number of water resources. It is having much of the agricultural farms, people have started coming back to the native places and they have started the farming. So all this has been possible because of the self-help group and the collective way to find out the solution to the problem. In this case, the problem was no water, and they tried to find out through water harvesting. So this is the first part, that is problem solving. The advantage is that as self-help groups, they help in problem solving. Then the second advantage would be the gender equality. Now they treat each member as equal, whether it is men or women, they treat each member as equal. So SHGs are mostly formed by female members, but they can be male members of the society also. Now these groups enable women to create a living for themselves, and these groups, they do provide their members with financial independence. Such steps, they do allow women to be less dependent on men. Now the third advantage is the employment opportunity. The SHEs, they often promote micro enterprises, and to sustain themselves, the members, they engage in some businesses based on their respective skills. Now in Northeast, if you go to that region, you would find the women making the bamboo furnitures, the bamboo products, because it is more available there. So you need to find out what is required in that particular place. So those, and what is the skill of the women. In some places, if you go to down south, you would find the textiles and the weaving industries or micro enterprises coming up, because there this kind of skill is available. So it depends how to generate the employment opportunity depends on the skills of the members and of that particular region, and that is helpful in generating the employment opportunity. Now this leads to the development of micro enterprises in rural areas, and such enterprises, they create employment opportunities for the members as well as other people. Now the fourth aspect is the financial discipline. Members of a self-help group, they are required to save the money. That is mandatory provision of self-help groups. So they are required to save the money, and then they create a pool of funds. Now this generates the mandatory requirement of saving the money. This generates a kind of financial discipline amongst the members. And this, this attitude can be dispersed to the other people of the society who may not be the members of the group. So the members then create a pool of funds from which any member can take a loan at low interest rate. So this is generating awareness also. The other members, they keep a check on the borrowing member. Now this is again very important, that monitoring is there. So the members, they keep on monitoring the members who have borrowed, so that they do not default on the repayment of rolls. So that is another important aspect. So this generates financial discipline. Now the fifth aspect is the benefits of the government schemes. So there are schemes available by the government for the rural people. So SHGs are entitled to several schemes from the government. So this information, it reaches to SHGs, and they try to use those schemes for the benefit of themselves, for their families, for the co-members, and for the society as a whole. So formation of these groups, it allows the government to easily locate the people who are entitled to government benefit. SHGs can even take bank loans. One such scheme is the SHG Bank Link scheme by NABARD. Now we come to the social benefits. It is easier for members to voice their opinion collectively. This is very important. The SHGs can take active part in rural democracy, such as panchayats. Now in this case, what happens in villages, if you go and if you see, usually the panchayats are formed of male members, and they have the domination over the women, and they take the decisions, and that decision is percolated to the families, respective families. But now if you see, there are lot many changes occurring even in panchayats. There are panchayats where the sarpanchs are women. And in rural democracy, this is one of the major changes. And they are ready to take the decisions. They are known to take the decisions independently. So in this case, SHGs play an important role in supporting those women and taking part in voicing their opinions. So they lead to rural development and bringing the social equality amongst the villages. The other strength or the advantage is the improved standard of living. This is one of the most important aspects. It's like when the poor is not understanding, they just need food and food for living, and say some kind of place to sleep, but they don't understand the importance of other parts like hygiene. They don't understand how to maintain the house. So the collective efforts by SHGs help in improving the living standards, and they are well aware on matters such as family planning, healthcare, employment and education for children. The last part is the open to all. It is open to all. It is participatory in nature, and there is no restriction on who can be the part of an SHG, but there is a restriction of number of members. So people from all castes, religions and income groups can join these members. Now to summarize, we can say that SHGs have many advantages, but these are the main. It generates self-employment, it increases the income level, it helps in women empowerment, it improves the standards of living, it alleviates poverty, and it generates self-reliance amongst, basically amongst the women. Thank you so much.